behalf of Elizabeth and Alexander, let me welcome you to this family celebration of dreams come true. Dreams come true in the union and love and commitment of Beth and Alex. And dreams come true for this setting, this time, this occasion, and the beauty of this day, which is a gift of the Father. But dreams come true in that union. What a fascinatingly diverse company we are, from locally, from across the world, coming together here to give our loving support to these two wonderful persons with all their promise, with all their dreams. They fell in love, they met and fell in love on the other side of the world. But they're here together, and we are delighted to be a part of their experience. An occasion like this merits the beautiful festooning and flowers and loveliness that an occasion like this merits. But it also is an occasion in its serious intention that merits being hallowed in prayer. So let's pray together, shall we? O God our Father, thank you for the gift of life and of love and of future. Elizabeth and Alexander, two of your children, stand together in the golden light of their love and yours. And we have the joy of standing with them. Thank you for the love and support of friends and family gathered here. Hallow this moment, Father, and fix it in all of our hearts and memory as an affirmation of their commitment to one another in self-giving love. Rightly do we celebrate it, and rightly do we solemnize it in its serious and loving intention and commitment to faithfulness to one another. If ever they are tempted to forget the promises given and received with loving purpose here, let them remember, even as we will remember. Surround and guide them with your eyes of love upon them, and grant us all your peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Who gives this woman to be married?
We do. Today I have a singular honor as the father of the bride to come together with this assembly and to be part of this union and this wedding. It's not every day that a dad gets to give away his daughter and perform the ceremony, and I appreciate the opportunity, both of you. To celebrate the union of Alexander and Elizabeth, we're celebrating quite a distance, both geographically and philosophically, from the civil union that we performed a little over a year ago for the two of them. And many of you in the room understand sometimes when you are in a different country than your birthplace, you have different visa requirements. And that requires maybe that if you want to actually have gainful employment, you might do a civil ceremony in order to expedite that opportunity. So today we are marking the family friends celebration, and as Dad put it, the intentionality of this union, and recognizing also that this is a journey. And marriage together, the relationship that you all have embarked upon, is truly a journey. And there are a lot of different steps along the way. As parents, all of us desire happiness for our children, even when our children are no longer children. We desire them to be happy. We desire them to find their soulmates. And Brian, I want to say on behalf of Jenny and I, we thank you and Vivian for raising such an amazing young man that Beth could find her soulmate in Alex. From our hearts to yours, thank you. From the south stands of Rugby Sevens, those of you that know might know that not every relationship that begins in the south stands of Rugby Sevens ends up where we are today. We celebrate the duration, the falling in love, the all the steps and challenges along the way, living apart, being together, looking for jobs, finding your way together, through all of the challenges that for many couples would dissuade you. And you were not, either of you, daunted. There's a word for that. It's called resilience. Love requires resiliency. Love expects that we are able to be loving with one another in spite of whatever might happen. So love requires resiliency. Rarely do our relationships go as planned, right? Sometimes there's some deviation along the way. But how we respond to each other, how we react, how we grow with one another defines who we will become as a couple, as a family. But more than just requiring resiliency, love provides resiliency. It's that space within the relationship for the messiness and the pain that will inevitably arrive to actually find comfort and nurture and strength in one another. From an architectural standpoint, and we're in some beautiful architecture today, an arch is stronger than two columns. So the arch that can lean together and lean on one another will hold much more strongly, much more enduringly than two who stand by themselves. The love of God strikes me as being perhaps the most resilient of all. I know that many of us would recognize the scripture passage out of 1 Corinthians, the love chapter, the 13th chapter. But I want to draw attention to some statements toward the end of that reading, verses 7 and 8, where love, and ask you all to reflect on these words, where it talks about love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. And so for you all, Alex and Beth, our hope, our desire is that you find that resiliency of love, God's love and your love for one another, that will bear and believe and hope and endure, knowing that love never ends, whatever it is that comes. One of the, and you know what, I feel like maybe perhaps you guys need to hold hands. So you just hold each other's hands and cut that. There's a song, and you might hear it later, and it has these words. Sometimes I catch her dreaming, and I wonder where that little mind meanders. Is she down along the shore or strolling across the broad savannas? I know in time she'll learn to make up her own mind. In time she's going to learn how to fly. Oh, that I won't deny. It's from a song called Little Miss Magic, and it's one that we have sung together over the years. And I think today, Beth, it strikes me that another flight is taking off. You have truly learned how to fly. And I respect that. Your mom and I often wonder, and we look in awe, and we recognize and we celebrate. You fly. You are not gone. And it was a flight that took you to Hong Kong. It was a flight that brought many of us here today. And you all are about to take off on yet another opportunity to fly as a couple. It's suitable for our global family, certainly, everyone who is gathered here. But Beth, as today goes, and you all begin this chapter in your lives, I want you to know that you will always be my little Miss Magic. However, today, the magic and wonder that you are in our lives and our family, that Mom and I have known so well over the years, is appropriately focused with Alex and your all's future together. So I hope that you find the magic and the wonder that we have known, and that that is an energy and an opportunity as you all celebrate your life together. Wendell Berry, in the voice of Hannah Coulter, one of his characters in a novel talking about community, and an amazingly empowered female character she is, reminds us that love is what carries you. Love is what carries you, for it is always there, even in the dark, or most in the dark, but shining out at times like the gold stitches in a piece of embroidery. May your love for one another today be embroidered upon your heart every day. May the resilience of your spirits carry you through the years, whatever comes. May you know the love and support of all of us gathered here in this beautiful space as you make your lives together. And may wisdom, compassion, faithfulness be your guides always. On behalf of your parents and family and friends, we ever so love you. be your husband and partner, to live together in the covenant of marriage. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Alexander, will you have Elizabeth to be your wife and partner, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
This is a reading from the Song of Solomon. My beloved speaks and says to me, "Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away with me." And now if you would all join me in prayer. Lord God, creator of marriage, bless this couple as they come in the presence of family and friends to affirm the choice they have made to accept each other as life companions. Confirm within both of them a desire to establish a home within your love and presence. Deliver them from empty commitments. May your spirit nurture them all the days of their lives. May they find in family and friends the encouragement to keep the vows they have made and to continue to grow in their walk together. Hear these petitions, we pray, with faith in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Share the whole of my life as wife and partner. I promise to love you and cherish you at all times.
I promise to love you and cherish you at all times.
And in all circumstances. I will respect you for the amazing person that you are.
Respect you, the amazing person you are,
and life you will be to me.
And life will be to me.
I will love you in sickness and in health.
I will love you in sickness and in health.
In the joyful and sad times of life.
In the joyful and sad times of life.
I will work together with you toward our shared goals.
I will work together with you toward our shared goals.
That we may honor our marriage always.
That we may honor our marriage always.
I, Elizabeth, take you, Alex, just as you are.
I, Elizabeth, take you, Alex, just as you are.
To share the whole of my life as my husband and partner.
To share the whole of my life as husband and partner.
I promise to love you and cherish you at all times. I
promise to love you and cherish you at all times.
And in all circumstances.
And in all circumstances.
I will respect you for the amazing person that you are.
I will respect you, the amazing person that you are.
And husband, you will be to me.
And husband, you will be to me.
I will love you in sickness and in health.
I will love you in sickness and in health.
In the joyful and sad times of life.
In the joyful and sad times of life.
I will work together with you toward our shared goals.
I will work together with you towards our shared goals.
That we may honor our marriage always.
That we will honor our marriage.
The ring is an outward and unbroken symbol
of the inward and enduring love within each of you. However, I would be remiss if in this moment I did not differentiate just a bit between the rings that you share here today and the ring that is at the epicenter of our family's favorite trilogy. They are, of course, the rings. These rings shall not be a temptation towards power, but rather the binding of your hearts and lives forever. Do not toss them into the fire of the mountain, but instead allow them children, Alex and Beth. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their lives together, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in troubles, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. May they grow in love and peace with you and with one another all the days of their lives. Give them grace when they hurt each other to recognize their fault and to seek each other's forgiveness. Make their lives together a sign of your love for our world, and may their relationship bring hope to all who know them. May the bonds of their marriage strengthen all our bonds of humanity, and may they live with compassion the life that awaits them. Amen. Now, as Elizabeth and Alexander have given themselves to one another with solemn vows, and the exchange of rings, it is my utmost joy to pronounce you both as husband and wife. Alex, you may kiss your bride. Woo!
Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Godspeed.